Second down and 7 yards to go. Goes through his progression. He avoids the rush by stepping up into the pocket. Picks up the ball and he can run. Is he going to score? He powers into the end zone for a touchdown.
The scoop, the scoot, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown. I don't think anybody was going to have a chance to catch him there.
Extra point is good. Time winds down here in the first with the score, the Bears. 7, the Texans. Nothing.
When you're returning kicks, you got to know when to take it out and when to just take a knee. And that is such a split-second decision. I really can't fault him there. He's just trying to make something happen.
It's first and 10. The Rock is on their own 13. The pocket collapsing.
Matt Schaub is one of the most accurate passers in the NFL, so when he slings one out of reach like that, you go, what the heck just happened?
They'll face second down and 10. The Rock is on their own 13. Passes it deep on the left side.
Matt Schaub really let that one go. He's definitely got the arm strength to make those kinds of throws, and everybody knows that, but accuracy is still the key to winning in this game.
Third down now, 10 yards for the first. Going down the middle with it. He's wrestled down right around the 34-yard line by Bauman. Good coverage downfield. Up top. Oh, he hauls it in.
Patience for a wide receiver is just so key. He's able to manipulate that defense, set him up one play, come back with the exact same look, and break off of it the next. Beautifully run.
First down and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. And looking right, he lets it go. He crosses the goal line. Touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. Rackers tacks on the extra point. Time one. Down here in the first with the score, the Texans. 7, the Bears. 7. Rackers is ready to kick this one off. Hester stands back to field the kick. The stop was made by Mario Williams. They'll take over at the 17-yard line. And we'll have a first down and 10.
Matt Forte really has a special sense of how a play is developing, and he knows the blocking assignments of those guys up front. You can just see it. He is very patient. He waits for it to develop and then takes full advantage.
First down, 10 to go. Takes a shot deep to... He's tackled around the 30-yard line by number 29. The big gain through the air sets up the offense with another first and 10. Under heavy pressure, gets it off and he takes a hit. And the tackle was made by Kareem Jackson.
I love that call against man-to-man coverage. Just get the ball out of your hands quickly. You don't have to face the pressure and give your playmakers a chance on that end cut.
Another run. Jason Allen was there to bring him down.
Matt Forte does as good a job as anybody out there. If it's a small hole, he finds a way to get through it. If it's a big hole, you see an explosion.
Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Again, he'll get the call.
You know you have a pretty special player at the running back position when, despite the fact that they're run blitzing him now, he can still get out of there and still come up with a nice game.
Short yardage situation here, second and a yard. And so, at the end of the first quarter, we're all even. Only a yard needed to convert here on second down. Inside handoff. And he's tackled right around the 2-yard line by Smith. Big opportunity for both teams here in this tie ball game. Ball on the one, third down. Cutler flips it out.
And as a quarterback, you have to start to recognize that. You just can't allow that safety to keep sniffing around that eighth man in the box and not throw the football. Essentially, they're daring this offense to throw it, and they're not taking advantage.
They call on the field goal unit. And the kick is good. Robbie Gould kicks it through to break the tie. Podlish is ready to kick it away. Manning is back to receive the kick. The Texans were able to put a scoring drive together on their last time out. The offense will take over at the 20. It's first and 10. Schaub gives it left. He's dropped down right around the 42-yard line by Bauman. Still looking for an open man. He's got it. Touchdown. Rackers adds the extra point. Looks like offside. Here's the official call.
The penalty
20 is the
Houston holds a four-point lead. Neil Rackers is just about ready to kick this one away. Hester is deep, looking to return the kickoff. The Bears take the field looking to put together a scoring drive. They came away with three the last time out. They'll start at the 17. First down and 10. Dumps it out right. Davis was the intended receiver. It's now second down, 10 yards to go. It's a quarterback sack.
Wow, he looked like a cyclone down there getting to the quarterback.
It is impressive when a guy that big is that nimble on his feet. He makes it look so easy, and it seems like he's past the offensive lineman as soon as the ball snapped. Tough to stop.
I'm just amazed he kept his balance.
Yeah, you know what's so incredible? He's running full speed and still has the agility to spin around the lineman, gather himself, and get to the quarterback. Just great athleticism.
To the 10, and the Bears roar back with a touchdown. And this attempt will give them a three-point advantage. Robbie Gould puts it through, and it's a three-point game. Chicago has a three-point cushion. Podlish will be kicking off. Number 22 stands back to field the kick. Podlish was there for the stop. The Texans got the ball into the end zone on their last possession. They'll get the ball here at the 29-yard line. And we'll have a first down and 10. Throws to his right. The stop was made by Major White.
And I can tell you this, there's nothing the defensive backs hate more than to have one of those big tight ends in the open field running right towards them.
First down, 10 to go. 2 minutes left in the half. Foster takes a handoff. He's brought down around the 48-yard line by Eden EJ. Searching for an open man. Fires it. His man is open. He cruises in for the touchdown. Rackers puts it through, and it's a four-point game. Houston is up by four. Neil Rackers looks ready to kick it away. Hester is back to receive the kick. The Bears ended their last drive with a touchdown, so they'll look to make it two in a row. They'll set up shop at the 20-yard line. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. He's searching for a receiver.
Pass rush almost got there that time, and he has to feel a little lucky. lucky that that ball just fell harmlessly to the turf.
So they'll face a second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Looking for a man. Hit hard as he throws.
And even though the blitz didn't get there that time, it just accelerated that clock in the quarterback's head, forced him to throw it out of there a little bit sooner than he wanted, and led to the incompletion.
That brings up third and 10. Passes out to his right. Fourth down now after the incomplete pass. The offense wasn't able to get on track during the last series.
Yeah, they just kind of looked out of sync from the very beginning there, and I thought first down really set the tone for that entire series.
So, it's fourth down. The Bears are lining up to punt this one away. And calls for the fair catch at the 27. They'll start this drive at the 27-yard line. It's first and 10. Has them deep. Going deep. He's got it. Touchdown. Rackers is good on the point effort. Houston is ready to kick this one off. Hester is deep, looking to return the kickoff. Brooks Reed was there to bring him down. The offense takes the field, hoping to put something together after their last drive ended in a three and out. First down and 10. Ball on their own 15. Surveys the field and looks left. Throws.
And defensively, you just can't ask for any better coverage than that. They are right there, but when you have a strong-arm quarterback like that, sometimes he can squeeze it into holes that others can't.
Goes through his progression. Fires a strike to the right.
That wide receiver's fast, but he's not that fast. My goodness, get him the football.
They'll face second down and 10. Ball on their own 41. Just gets it away. Watch out, he's got space. He's looking for a burst of speed. Feet don't fail me now. He's in. Touchdown. And they'll try to tack on 2 points here. Has a man out to his right. Podlish gets ready to kick it away. Manning stands back to field the kick. He'll down it in the end zone. The Texans will look to build momentum by getting another touchdown on this series. The offense will start at the 20. And we'll have a first down and 10. Good coverage downfield. Going deep toward the left sideline. It looks like he was able to bring it down in bounds. They'll discuss it. Phone 49-yard line. They're going for the home run. Touchdown, Texans. Neil Racker tacks on the extra point. Rackers is just about ready to kick this one away. Number 18 is back to receive the kick. The Bears were able to put a scoring drive together on their last time out. And the tackle was made by Brandon Harris. They'll take over at the 16. First down, 10 to go. Still looking for an open man. He's wrestled down at about the 35-yard line by number 29. Now we have a down and 10 to go. He's going to his right. Throws. Davis was his intended target. That'll make it second down with 10 to go. They're on their own 35. Searching for an open man. And they got him. The Texans will take their first timeout of the half. After the sack, they're going to be looking at a third down and long play here. He's searching for a receiver. Shuffles his feet in the pocket, and he's sacked. The sack brings up a fourth and very long situation. Signals for the fair catch at the 30. They'll go to work at the 30. It's first and 10. Makes the throw over the middle. And he drops the short pick. We'll have to see how both teams respond as the second half kickoff is just seconds away.
Yeah, no question. He would have definitely been better off just taking a knee on that one. He was trying to make something happen, but I'm sure his coach is going to have a little something to say to him when he gets to the sideline.
The offense will take over at the 12. First down and 10. Looking for a man. He knocks it away at the last second.
Boy, the quarterback has to be a better decision maker than that. There's no way he was going to get that one in.
Down and 7 yards to go. Surveys the field. Looks right. Throws.
And when you throw a football that hard, it just leaves no margin for error because there's no room for the wide receiver to make an adjustment.
Third down now, 10 yards for the first. Ball on their own 12. And the ball on the 12. Throws to his left. He's tackled around the 38-yard line by Manning. Goes through his progression, buying time with his feet. The stop was made by Mario Williams. Brings up second and nine. Good coverage downfield. There's the deep throw. He's wide open downfield. Is he going to score? Touchdown, Bears. Extra point is good. So, time winding down in the third. Score, the Bears. 30, the Texans. 35.
Sometimes in that situation, you see a guy break it out of there for a big gainer, and the crowd goes crazy, and everybody's excited, and sometimes you get stopped inside the 20, and it hurts your team.
Schaub can hear the crowd in the end zone seats from this starting field position. Dumps it short.
Matt Schaub is one of the most accurate passers in the NFL, so when he slings one out of reach like that, you go, what the heck just happened?
It's now second down, 10 yards to go. Throws middle of the field. Tries to juke the defender, and he will be tackled. Gain of nine. They'll throw for the first. Corey Wooten was there for the stop. The Big O makes his third grab. Still looking for an open man. He's going deep. Walter was the intended receiver. The intended target. Second down. So they'll face a second and 10. The ball is on their own 16. Here's the give. And he's running with a purpose now. Racing toward the end zone. Gone. Get this man a new contract. Puts on a move. Touchdown. Neil Racker adds the extra point. So, time winding down in the third with the score. The Texans, 42. The Bears, 30. Neil Racker will be kicking off. Hester is deep, looking to return the kickoff. And the tackle was made by Barber. The Bears ended their last drive with a touchdown, so they'll look to make it two in a row. They'll set up shop at the 22. And we'll have a first down and 10. Searching for an open man. This is close. Did he come up with it? First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 39. Passes out to the left.
And you know the amazing thing about this guy, we all talk about strength, but did you see how fluid that delivery? Didn't even look like he was trying.
He searched for a seat, dumps it out. Challenge to bring him down. Knocks cards with. The three on second down. Through his right. Another on this drive. Deep coming with.
But you know it if you were wide back. He's in there strong. Comeback defense pay that time.
Steps and throws to the left. William was the intended receiver on the play.
Any gusher like that. Very seldom are those painted.
Face second down and 10. Rolls it quickly out left, looking to pass. Passes out to his right. The stop was made by Jonathan Joseph.
The Bears continue to show their superiority in the passing. After the first half they had, you would have thought that maybe they would have faced something a little different here in the third quarter.
Looking, fires it to the left, comes down with it, touchdown! And he adds the point after. So, time winding down in the third with the score. The Bears, 37. The Texans, 42.
Well, he took a gamble on that one. And as we all know, sometimes you gamble and it pays off. Sometimes you gamble and you're inside the 20.
The Texans have the ball and the lead as we begin the fourth quarter. They'll start at the 11. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Foster on the run.
Number 23 gets the ball.
And he's tackled around the 12-yard line by Melton. Second and 7 situation here. It's the tailback. Julius Peppers was there for the stop. They go to their hurry-up offense. Delayed handoff. Huge gash right up the middle. He's brought down around the 39-yard line. by Jennings. It's first and 10. And with that, the 2-minute warning is reached. First down and 10. There are 2 minutes to go in this football game. Foster, the ball carrier. Julius Peppers was there to bring him down. 5-yard pickup. It's now 2nd and 5. They'll give it off here. He's dropped down around the 47-yard line by Adams. That'll make it 3rd down. The offense needs about 3 feet for the first. Short throw to the right. Lance Briggs was there for the stop.
And that's good quarterback play. He recognized the blitz. He understood what was happening with the coverage behind it and found the open man.
And we'll have a 1st down and 10. Ball on the 43. They weren't able to get the playoff. That will cost them 5.
The layup game on the offense. 1st down.
So the penalty makes it 1st and 15. He takes a knee. So they'll face a 2nd and 17 situation. Ball at midfield.
No fun for the running back. It's one thing to get stuffed at the line of scrimmage, but when you start losing yards running the football, that's a disaster.
3rd down and long coming up here. Ball on their own 46.